This lecture will go from the ancient Sumerian lyre to the modern piano by way of various lutes, guitars, and harpsichords. Plucked string instruments were an early invention of mankind. This extraordinary Sumerian lyre of nearly 5,000 years ago used to be in the Baghdad Museum, but was destroyed in the recent looting. However, a reconstruction has been lovingly made. The strings on a lyre are all roughly the same length, variation in pitch coming from adjusting the tension. There's a sounding box at the bottom to amplify the sound. It's known only that the strings were non-metallic, but whether they were made of silk or gut or horsehair or leather, we don't know. Sheep's gut was used for the copy. The long strings have a deep, magical sound.
Shiduri said, "Gilgamesh, where are you roaming? You will never find the eternal life that you seek." When the gods created mankind, they also created death, and they held back eternal life for themselves alone.
Only a mere 2,500 years old, these pictures of Egyptian harps show a different approach, using differing lengths of string to obtain the range of pitches. The music is derived from ancient Greek manuscripts. To get pitches similar to the harp on such small instruments as these from ancient Greece, thicker strings must have been used. The folk lyre had a tortoise shell resonator. The kithara, on the other hand, was the instrument of professionals. Its soundboard, on the same plane as the strings, could reflect the sound across an open-air amphitheatre.